Hi, I'm Holli. I work at NASA Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, and today I'm here to talk to you about land cover. Land cover is what is on the land around us. It's trees, it's grass, it's pavement, it's buildings, all those kinds of things, and it's important for lots of reasons. I have with me my assistant, Isabel. Isabel, how old are you?
Three.
Very good. All right, Isabel, we're going to build a park. Can you build a park with Legos for me?
Well, yeah, I need a little help.
You need a little help? Okay. What are we building?
A park.
Okay. Well, while we're building a park, it's really important that it's on the land for lots of reasons. Land cover is a really basic measurement to use to study all kinds of things. It's used to tell us where animals can live. It's used to help us understand how water flows over the ground, where it soaks in and where it just runs off. And it's helpful in helping us know what kinds of disasters your community might be at risk for, such as landslides or floods or fires. One reason NASA's interested in land cover is it tells us a little bit about how the planet is responding to changes in temperature and weather patterns like rainfall. And so we can see that plants are changing on a large scale or not. So, Isabel, how's your park coming along?
Fine.
Can you tell me a little bit about it?
I think
Well, should we build a tree in your park?
No
trees? Okay. Well, what is in your park? Is this a lot of grass?
Yeah.
And what else is in your park?
In all of the grass. Here's the grass where we can have a picnic.
Oh, that's great. We have grass for a picnic. Great. Well, let's build. Can Mommy help you a little bit?
Yeah.
How about we build a tree or swings or a slide? Well, let's pretend there's a big tree right here. And you are hiding behind the tree.
And playing hide and seek.
Yeah, we're playing hide and seek in the park. Could you see, if you're hiding behind the tree, could you see the grass over here?
No.
No, you couldn't. Now let's pretend that you're a birdie or you're way up high on an airplane, okay? We're gonna hold this up like this. So we're holding it up like this. Okay, now if you're way, way, way up high, can you see over here?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you can see over here at the same time, huh?
But I can see everything.
Yeah, you can see everything when it's way up high like that. But when you're down flat like this, you can't see everything. Can you see underneath the tree if you're up on top? No, the leaves are hiding things underneath, huh? So different ways of seeing show us different things and they teach us different things about what's on the land. So if I were doing this with an older child, you can keep building your park. Thank you, sweetheart. If I were doing this with an older child, I might give them a picture of a park and ask them to recreate that before we have that conversation about what's in the park. For a teenager, you could use a satellite image. This is a maps image from an internet mapping program, and you can zoom down into your neighborhood and put a grid over it and have them recreate that in Legos. And in that case, I would use Legos that are uniform in color, and I would assign a land cover type. So, you know, dark green might be forested or trees, and lighter green might be grass. So they could build based on a satellite image like this, or we could get a broader view, which is what NASA uses. This is an image from the Landsat satellite, and we put a grid over it again, and they can build out the broader view. Now, the interesting thing here is one of these small squares is about equivalent to one of these squares, or a couple of these squares to get the aspect ratio. So you would see that, you know, in here you might classify this as city and grass, pavement, Whereas in this square, this entire thing would be pavement. So you're missing details when you get out at this scale. However, if you're going to map the whole planet, this is the scale you want, because you can see, you can get a big area and you can make bigger maps more quickly. But each scale is important. So NASA does map land cover from space using satellites like Landsat, but you can help. Using Globe Observer, you can help us map land cover. Globe Observer is a citizen science program. It's a free app and it is available in Google Play and in the App Store. And you just need an email address to register. And when you register, there's a few different things you can do in there, but one of them is called land cover. And to help us take a land cover observation, all you do is you take a picture of the land facing north, south, east, and west, and we'll show you where those are inside the app. And then you classify, you tell us what's in your picture. Is it trees? Is it grass? What do you see there? This is what that looks like inside the app. So it's a pretty easy just drop down menu there, and you click on what you see. And then the last step is optional. You can tell us if what you're seeing is the same thing as what the satellite's seeing. And there's lots of reasons why it might be a little different, including the scale that I just showed you. So thank you for joining us today. We hope that we get to work with you in the future as you help us map land cover through Globe Observer.